Okay, stay good.
Very good.
How about two? Perfect. Good? Thank you.
Να συγχαρώ το Pan Gregorian για τη διοργάνωση αυτής της όμορφης εκδήλωσης. Να τους ευχαριστήσω για όσα κάνουν στο φιλανθρωπικό τομέα. Να συγχαρώ και το St. Basil's Academy για την τιμητική διάκριση που θα λάβει απόψε και τον διευθυντή, τον Πάτερ. Και το έργο τους είναι πολύ σημαντικό για τον λόγο ότι δίνουν μια δεύτερη ευκαιρία σε παιδιά τα οποία υπό άλλες συνθήκες μπορεί να παίρνουν ένα πολύ άσχημο δρόμο. Τους δίνουν την ευκαιρία να μεγαλώσουν, να διαπρέψουν και να έχουν χαμόγελο και ελπίδα στη ζωή.
Καλησπέρα σας. Δημήτρης Κοντολιός, Δημοτικός Σύμβουλος του Richfield, New Jersey και Πρόεδρος στα Ηνωμένα Χιακά Σωματεία Αμερικής και Καναδά. Συγχαρητήρια πάλι στο Pan Gregorian Enterprises και το Foundation, το Ίδρυμα, που μια πανέμορφη βραδιά απόψε στο Venetian. Είναι το ετήσιο. Συγχαρητήρια στον τιμημένο Πάτερ Σιταρά και τον Άγιο Βασίλειο. Μας κάνουν μεγάλη δουλειά και φροντίζουν και περιποιάνται όλα τα ορφανά. Έχουμε πάει στον Άγιο Βασίλειο εμείς στο Garrison. Έχουμε υποστηρίξει ως χιώτες το Academy και ελπίζω καλή συνέχεια. Καλές γιορτές όλοι. Συγχαρητήρια πάλι στο Pan Gregorian, σε όλα τα εστιατόρια και συγγενείς και φίλοι μου που είναι μέλη στην οργάνωση και καλή επιτυχία.
Νίκος Μπάρδης, αντιπρόεδρος του Pan Gregorian of America και ταμείας του Pan Gregorian Νέας Υόρκης. Είμαστε εδώ για πολλωστή φορά σε ένα καταπληκτικό dinner όπως βλέπετε στο Βενίσια για φιλανθρωπικό πάντα σκοπό. Τιμάμε την Ακαδημία του Αγίου Βασιλείου. Είμαστε περήφανοι που είμαστε μέλη του Pan Gregorian.
Hi, με λένε Θέμη Κοντολιού και χαίρομαι που είμαι στο Pan Gregorian Charity Gala, γιατί είναι ένα πολύ σημαντικό οργανισμό που βοηθάει και νοσοκομεία και άρρωστους και παιδιά. Και σήμερα τιμούν ένα πολύ σημαντικό άνθρωπο από το St. Basil's Academy, ο Father Σιταράς, και είμαι χαρούμενη που βρίσκομαι εδώ μαζί με όλη την παρέα που πάντα έχει πάρα πολύ κόσμο και πάρα πολλούς εθελοντές. Τα εστιατόρια, τα diners που έχουμε, έχουν κάποια στήριξη από Ελληνοαμερικάνους για τα προϊόντα και για support και χαίρομαι πάρα πολύ που βρίσκομαι και εγώ εδώ με αυτό το group.
Καλησπέρα. Χαιρετούμε όλους. Αυτή η εκδήλωση του Pan Gregorians είναι yearly. Γνώρισα τους Pan Gregorians χρόνια πριν, the 80s and 90s, που κάναμε πολύ μεγάλα πράγματα για το Charitable Foundation. Και σήμερα είναι η μέρα τους, είναι η μεγαλύτερη μέρα του Pan Gregorian, διότι σήμερα θα γίνουν δωρεές πάνω των 100.000 δολαρίων σε άλλους διαφορετικούς οργανισμούς. Είναι μια εκδήλωση που την στηρίζουμε κάθε χρόνο και πρέπει να τη στηρίζουμε, γιατί αυτά πρέπει να συμβαίνουν. Αυτές είναι οι εκδηλώσεις. Ευχαριστώ.
Καλησπέρα, ο Φίλιππος Βαγιατζόγλου με το Hellenic Relief Foundation. Σήμερα έχουμε μια πολύ ωραία μέρα εδώ και θέλω να ευχαριστήσω το Pan Gregorians για όλα αυτά που έχουν κάνει και πιστεύω με την οργάνωση αυτή εξακολουθούν πάρα πολλά καλά έργα και σας ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ για την εκδήλωση αυτή που κάνετε.
Λοιπόν, είναι μια εκδήλωση η οποία είναι θεσμός κάθε χρόνο. Είμαστε πάρα πολύ περήφανοι που έχουμε έναν οργανισμό όπως το Pan Gregorian στην Ομογένεια. Το Pan Gregorian του New Jersey έχει μια φοβερή ιστορία, μια πολύ μεγάλη προσφορά στα κοινά και μια πολύ μεγάλη προσφορά στη φιλανθρωπία. Είμαι πολύ χαρούμενος που βρίσκομαι εδώ. Βεβαίως, ένα μεγάλο μπράβο στον σημερινό πρόεδρο, τον κύριο Λογοθέτη. Και φυσικά είναι και μια ιδιαίτερη εκδήλωση σήμερα, γιατί είναι και η πρώτη φορά που λείπει ένας μεγάλος ευεργέτης, ο Γιάννης ο Σακελάρης. Το κλίμα είναι φορτισμένο ούτως ή άλλως εκ των πραγμάτων, αλλά θεωρώ ότι από εκεί πάνω που βρίσκεται θα είναι χαρούμενος που το έργο του συνεχίζεται και νομίζω ότι όλοι μας οφείλουμε να στηρίζουμε οργανισμούς όπως το Pan Gregorian.
Όποιον είναι, θα τον πιάσω. Όλα καλά, πάτερα.
If I could ask everybody to take a seat. We'd like to get the program going. On behalf of Mr. George Tsimboulos, the chairman of the gala, my name is Agapios Kritsis, the chairman of Pan Gregorian. I'd like to take this opportunity, I'd like to introduce the master of ceremonies, a good friend. His name is James Polos. He's executive director of the Middlesex County Improvement Authority. He's a former freeholder from Middlesex County, former mayor of Highland Park. He's also an Archon of the Ecumenical Patriarch, member of the Metropolis Council. He's also participating in helping manage the new Metropolitan Housing Project down in Perth Amboy for senior citizens. And most importantly, he's the father of three daughters, and just an overall good guy. I'd like to welcome James Polos.
Thank you, Agapios. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Pan Gregorian Foundation 35th anniversary celebration. A round of applause for everyone involved in this wonderful event. This is an exciting evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very important and special evening for the Foundation as it honors St. Basil's Academy and for the great work that it's done during the 35 years that it's been in existence. It is a particularly special organization to me as one who was involved in many organizations because I remember as a young boy my father coming home to talk about an idea that a man had. That man was George Manolius. George Manolius was my father's partner at the Princetonian Diner back in the 1980s. And my father would come home at night and say that George had an idea for this type of an organization. And through his spirit, through his creativity, and through the hard work and dedication of the founding fathers of this organization, and over the years, those who have shown their stewardship to see this organization grow and prosper. This organization has been able to bestow upon needy children and other organizations in a charitable way over $2.5 million. I think that deserves a round of applause, a significant round of applause. And ladies and gentlemen, that doesn't just come as a result of the leadership of this organization, but it comes as a result of all of you. Every single one of you who buys a ticket, places an ad, every vendor, every supporter for every type of an event that they put together, you should know in your heart that those dollars are going for good causes. And when we think of charity, in fact, if you go back and look at the New Testament, the word charity was often used to describe the word agape, which in Greek means love. And it is the love of the hearts of those people who run this organization that allow this organization to be such a success. So it is truly an honor and a privilege to be your MC tonight. We're gonna get through our introductions. We have some presentations to make. And then tonight, we want you to enjoy yourselves, dance and have fun with some great music and be able to meet your colleagues and friends from other districts. We wanna welcome everyone from New Jersey, Pennsylvania, New York, and the surrounding communities that are here tonight. A round of applause for everyone who's here from in-state and out-of-state. It is important that we recognize the many honored guests that are with us today, and of course, I cannot start without indicating the strong support and love and affection of our spiritual leader at the Metropolis of New Jersey. His Eminence Metropolitan Evangelos is with us this evening. A gentleman who attends many events and shows his true dedication to the Greek community and his spirit through his spirit and heart, and a very, very good gentleman, a good friend, His Excellency the Honorable Dr. Konstantinos Koutras, Consul General of Greece in New York. We're also pleased to have with us the Consul General of the Republic of Cyprus in New York with us as well, a very honorable gentleman, Mr. Alexis Phaedonos Vaidet. Of course, we have tonight's honorees, and a big round of applause for our honorees. If you've never been to St. Basil's Academy, you're going to learn about it tonight, and you will see what great work that they do under the direction and stewardship of Father Constantine Sitaris. A warm round of applause for Father Sitaris and the children of St. Basil's Academy. Representing the New Jersey Attorney General's Office, Mr. John McGuire. You had the pleasure of meeting the chairman of the Pan Gregorian Board a few moments ago, Mr. Agapios Kiritsis. Although he couldn't be with us tonight, a gentleman who we all know very well, who has been a steward of this organization for many, many years, the honorary president of Pan Gregorian Enterprise, is Mr. George Sambulis. Mr. Stephen Gunatis, president of St. Basil's Academy. Mr. Nick Vardis, president of PGE Metro New York. Where are you, Nick? Welcome. We also have with us Chris Scarbadonis, president of PGE of New England. These gentlemen have traveled far with their entourage, and we appreciate them being with us this evening. Mr. George Moustakis, president of PGE of Upper New York. Chris Saltos, First Capital. Panos Yorgopoulos, Elitis Chair, Founder, President, and Rutgers University Representative. Spiridula Katechis, Ronald McDonald House, Greek Division. Mr. Lou Giordino, Chief of the Fire Department of Kenilworth, is with us this evening. Let's hear it for our first responders who do a wonderful job out there each and every day for us. Miss Nancy Kennedy and Miss Amy Glazer from Hackensack University Medical Center Foundation. One of our past honorees, Mr. Andreas Komodromos. We're very proud of one of our Greek elected officials from the town of Ridgefield. He's a councilman there, Mr. Dimitri Kontolios. President of the Cyprus Children's Fund, Mr. Nick Zitis, is with us this evening. The Executive Vice President of the Cypriot American Organizations, Mr. Nikos Pathitis, is with us. We're glad to have Phil Voges here, the founder of the Hellenic Relief Foundation. Dr. Panos Stavianidis, the Executive Vice President of the Hellenic Federation of New Jersey, welcome. Mr. Yanni Kontolios, who's the President of the Chian Federation. Mr. Stelios Kontolios, who's president of the Kambusion Association. Stathis Zambas, who's president of the Cypriot Association of New Jersey. We have with us the Honorable Judge Marina Korodimus, who's spearheading the new Metropolis housing project in Perth Amboy with us tonight. Mr. Gregory Hasapis, Chairman of Youth Professionals at Greek American Chamber of Commerce, and Mr. Stavros Antonakakis, Treasurer of the Pan-Cretan Association of America. I would also like to welcome all the media who are here tonight, both television and print and radio. Thank you for the coverage that you give to this wonderful event. It is through your expression of word that people are able to find out the great work and deeds that Pan Gregorian does throughout the state. Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention now for a moment, I would like to invite up a special young lady who is going to sing our national anthems. And once she concludes the Greek and American national anthems, she will be singing a special selection, a very special selection for her uncle,
John Sakellaris. It is my pleasure to introduce John's niece, Yulia Vergis, to sing.
Και σαν πρώτα Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to just pause for a moment and think about those beautiful words as we reflect upon a wonderful man, a great grandfather, father, uncle, colleague, husband, friend, a gentleman with an impeccable reputation, not only in New Jersey, not only in the United States, but internationally. He was a gentleman that you could always go to for help, support, guidance, and he never looked for the credit or the notoriety for it. He was there for his fellow man, his fellow Greek. Loved when Greeks got involved. I remember the first time I ran for office, he was so excited you thought he was running for office. He just wanted me to be a success. That's what John Sakellaris is all about. So I ask you to reflect for just a moment on the beauty of his life, his legacy, and the fact that he was a pillar of support for this great organization that we celebrate tonight called Pan Gregorian. In a few minutes, I'm going to be inviting up his grandson for a very special presentation, but before I do that, I would like to introduce an individual who is a special person to all of us. You know, as Greek Americans, as Greeks, we pursue different careers in life. We become restaurant owners, we get into politics, we do businesses, pharmaceuticals, whatever it may be, but we have one common thread, and that common thread is our culture and our Orthodox religion. And it is therefore a special moment for us tonight, and an undeniable relationship between Pan Gregorian and the metropolis of New Jersey that exists, to introduce our spiritual leader, the person who leads our flock every day and gives us his love, guidance, and tender hand to make sure that we're making the right decisions in our lives. Our spiritual leader is Eminence Metropolitan Evangelist of New Jersey.
Ως και εμείς επίμεις ο λέξης ημών, και εμείς νέκτης μας παιδεσμών, αλλά εις εμάς από το Ιερούμε. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Λόξα πατρίκια, Υιό και Πνεύματι, καινή και εξαισθητοῦς των ἀμήν, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, δέσποτα ευλόγησον.
Χριστέ ο Θεός ευλόγησον, πρόσκειν υπός των φίλων σου, ότι άγιος θα πάμε σε νίκαια ή και εις αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν, Λόρα, God bless the fruit and drink of your servants now and always, and unto the age of ages. Amen. Καλή σας όλης.
Thank you, Yermans. You may be seated. As part of our special presentation tonight and our special remembrance for the beautiful John Sakellaris, it's my honor to introduce to you his grandson, Yannis Sakellaris Logothetis, who will be making a special presentation to the Hackensack Hospital Tomorrow Children's Fund. And in order to receive that special presentation, I'd like to invite Nancy Kennedy up, please, from the hospital as well. Just been informed that Amy Glazer is also here from the hospital, so we'd like to invite both Nancy and Amy up as well. And now I've been told that Amy couldn't make it this evening.
Our family wish that in lieu of flowers,
could I have your attention for 1 second?
Our family wish that in lieu of flowers, all monetary donations in loving memory of our grandfather be sent to the PGEI of America Charitable Foundation and donated to the Hackensack University Medical Center Foundation for children's cancer research. The total amount collected was $17,440. And we also have one more donation in memory of our grandfather from Dimitri and Kalliopi Panayotou for $2,000. Oh, I'm sorry, the $2,000 is to St. Basil's Academy.
Another round of applause, please, for a beautiful presentation. I know those dollars will be put to good use at both the hospital as well as St. Basil's Academy. It's now a privilege to introduce to you the man who is at the helm of the board of Pan Gregorian Enterprises, the chairman of the board for Pan Gregorian Enterprises, Mr. Agapios Kenitsis.
Thank you, Jim. It's been an interesting year as chairman, following in some really, really large footsteps. I didn't know Mr. Sakellaris for a long time, but one thing of value he said to me a couple months before he passed away, he said to me, "No, Agapios, you're not Carpathian, but you're okay." I took this year to try to meet as many of the past members in the past, over the 36 years, past presidents, past chairmen, and try to get an understanding of where they see Pan Gregorian. Pan Gregorian's had a wonderful past. Here we are today, 36 years later, and now we've got to paint a picture for the future. How are we going to embrace that future? For any successful organization, you need three main pillars to be understood. Number one, we have to be an educated organization to understand the market, understand our position, understand what we do, understand our identity. The second major pillar is administration and accountability. Without good administration and accountability, we go nowhere. Number three, the most important right now, which I'm going to talk about a little bit, is really the mission of Pan Gregorian Enterprises. The bottom line is Pan Gregorian Enterprises is a group, it's a purchasing co-op. We're here to serve our business, our family, our church, our society, and our friends. And in order to accomplish this, requires commitment, loyalty, passion, pride. We have some wonderful programs that we're going to be rolling out. We're also taking the time now to really assess all of our strategic alliances. It's very important that Pan Gregorian appreciates and values the relationships it has. We can't do this without the success and the good relationship with all our vendors. I implore all you members to participate in all the programs. A lot of the vendors are here tonight. Make it a point to get to know them, introduce yourselves. But one of the most important reasons why we're here tonight is the subject of gratitude. Pan Gregorian Charitable Foundation is a wonderful organization that gives back to the community. We're giving back for scholarships, we're giving back to hospitals, our metropolis, church causes, housing projects. And this is important, the spirit of giving back. And in order to give back, we must have gratitude for what we have. And it's interesting that tonight we honor Father Costa and St. Basil's Academy. So if you've had the pleasure of working with Father Costa, you'll get to learn one thing, and that's the power of the Holy Spirit. And in order to give back and show gratitude, means to acknowledge the power and the strength of the Holy Spirit. And that's the one thing you will learn working with Father Costa is that. And I salute. I salute all the members. I salute the future. Kalliorixi, thanks for the time. I'm under a 3-minute gag order. I could go on and on, but that's it for me. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now an honor and privilege. We are blessed tonight that we have with us not only the Consul General from Greece, but also from Cyprus. And therefore, it is a pleasure to introduce to you the Honorable Mr. Alexis Phedonos Vadet, the Consul General of the Republic of Cyprus in New York. Mr. Consul General.
Your Eminence, Mr. President of the Pan-Gregorian, Mr. Consul General of Greece, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to first of all congratulate the whole family of the Pan-Gregorian for organizing this beautiful event, but also for their decades-long support of humanity and all their efforts to help the less fortunate members of our society, and all the work they have done in the areas of philanthropy. Allow me to also join you in honoring the Reverend Father and St. Basil's Academy. Their work is invaluable to us. We highly appreciate the work that they have done as a government. They have given opportunities to young children of the Orthodox community, opportunities which, if it hadn't been for the St. Basil's Academy and the support given by the Pan-Gregorian and the Metropolis, these children might have had a completely different path of life, a much darker path of life. So thanks to the Metropolis and His Eminence, thanks to the Pan-Gregorian family and to St. Basil's Academy, an opportunity is given to hundreds of children to have a much better and prosperous and bright and Christian life. Thank you very much once again, and enjoy the evening.
It's a pleasure now to introduce the Consul General of Greece in New York, the Honorable Dr. Konstantinos Koutras. Please give him your attention.
Σεβασμιότατε, σεβαστοί πατέρες, κύριε Πρόεδρε, κυρίες και κύριοι. Πριν ξεκινήσω να μιλήσω σήμερα, θα ήθελα να αναγνωρίσω ένα πρόσωπο που ο Τζίμ ίσως δεν τον ήξερε, γι' αυτό δεν τον είπε. Ένα νέο πρόσωπο, ένα νέο Έλληνα που κατάγεται από την Κερίνια, το Μάικ Τοντανούσι, ο οποίος θα τρέξει για τις εκλογές στο Staten Island και το Brooklyn και ελπίζω να έχει την υποστήριξή μας. Μπράβο, Μάικ. Είναι μεγάλη μου χαρά να απευθύνω χαιρετισμό στην σημερινή σας βραδιά. Κάθε χρόνο βλέπουμε με εξαιρετική συγκίνηση τη μεγάλη αυτή οικογένεια των Pan-Gregorian, σε εσάς, να μεγαλώνει και να βλέπω πιο ισχυρούς τους δεσμούς που έχετε δημιουργήσει τόσες δεκαετίες. Έχοντας το προνόμιο να έχω τιμηθεί προσωπικά από τον οργανισμό πέρσι, σε αυτήν εδώ την αίθουσα, επιτρέψτε μου δύο λόγια σε ένδειξη εκτίμησης για το αξιέπαινο φιλανθρωπικό σας έργο. Η Pan-Gregorian Enterprises δεν είναι μόνο ένα επαγγελματικό δίκτυο. Είναι ένα δίκτυο προστασίας που προσφέρει γενναιόδωρα στήριξη και καθοδήγηση, κυρίες και κύριοι. The Pan-Gregorian Enterprises have gone above and beyond their initial mission. Pan-Gregorian Enterprises is not just a professional association. It is a network transformed into a safety net to provide support and guidance. In other words, it is an asset for our Hellenic American community, Mr. President. Τον προηγούμενο χρόνο, το 2019 μάλλον, τους προηγούμενους μήνες, σημαδεύτηκε από την απώλεια ενός πολύ σημαντικού ανθρώπου. Ενός ανθρώπου που βρισκόταν στο τιμόνι του οργανισμού αυτού, τον Τζον Σακελάρη. Θεωρώ μεγάλη μου τιμή που γνώρισα αυτόν τον άνθρωπο. Εκτίμησα την ακεραιότητά του, την αφοσίωσή του, την αγάπη του προς την πατρίδα, τη λατρεία του προς την οικογένειά του. Θα λείψει σε όλους μας, κι ας είναι αιωνία η μνήμη του. The Pan Gregorian are not the same without John Sakellaris. I consider myself privileged to have met a man of integrity, a man of principles, and a strong supporter of Hellenism here in the United States. He will be missed. Ωστόσο, η ζωή συνεχίζεται. Γι' αυτό και πιστεύω σήμερα ότι ο πατέρας Κωνσταντίνος Σιταράς είναι η ενσάρκωση αυτής της αποστολής που έχουμε σαν άνθρωποι και σαν χριστιανοί. Εκπροσωπώντας την Ελλάδα σε αυτό το μοναδικό κομμάτι των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών, είχα την ευκαιρία να δω από κοντά το φιλανθρωπικό και μορφωτικό έργο που επιτελείται στην Ακαδημία του Αγίου Βασιλείου. Σας διαβεβαιώνω ότι νιώθω την ίδια συγκίνηση κάθε φορά που με τιμά η Ακαδημία με την πρόσκλησή της και με γεμίζει ακόμα μεγαλύτερη υπερηφάνεια η σκέψη πόσο μπορεί να ανθίσει η ψυχή με τη δύναμη της πίστης μας. Κλείνοντας, θα πω πως δεν είναι τυχαίο που στα ελληνικά, τη γλώσσα μας, έχουμε το ίδιο ρήμα για να περιγράψουμε την Ανάσταση, σεβασμιότατε, με την ανατροφή των παιδιών. Τι λέμε? Λέμε «αναστένω ένα παιδί» και εννοούμε ότι το βοηθάμε να μεγαλώσει. Και εδώ είναι ένα άλλο κρίσιμο σημείο για τα αυριανά Ελληνόπουλα. Το χρέος μας να τα βοηθήσουμε να προκόψουν. Και αυτό πρέπει να το κάνουμε όπως οι Pangregorians, όπως ο πατήρ Κωνσταντίνος, με αλτρουισμό και αυταπάρνηση. In English, we say it takes a village to raise a child. And I regret not having anything equivalent in Greek to prove the importance of this saying. Our duty towards the future generation should be placed above professions, careers, and earthly praise. Father Kostas knows that he has been serving this mission with unwavering dedication. Η Ελλάδα είναι υπόχρεη. Σας ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ και συγχαρητήρια.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could just have your attention for a few moments, I know we want to all meet each other and commiserate a little bit. We only have a few minutes left in our program, and we would appreciate your attention for the speakers who have traveled very far and bring very important words to this evening's event. It is now an honor and privilege to introduce, on behalf of His Eminence Archbishop Elpidophoros, Father Nicholas Anctil, for a few words. Father?
Καλησπέρα σας. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Might you turn your attention a little bit longer, as our good MC has said. Thank you so much, really. Your Eminence, Metropolitan Evangelos of New Jersey, thank you for allowing me the honor and the pleasure of coming this evening to be in your metropolis to share the blessings of His Eminence Archbishop Elpidophoros, who has asked me to come this evening to express my congratulations not only to the Pan-Gregorians, but also to Father Constantine Sitaris, to his Presbytera Val, to his son Basil, and to his beautiful Nifi Irini, who are all here with you this evening. And I thank you very much for this opportunity to congratulate Father Costa. I also wanted to share with you the joy that Holy Trinity Church in New Rochelle receives, because we have been the beneficiaries of the Pan-Gregorian Association, Society, and Fellowship with our youth programs at Holy Trinity Church. And lastly, ladies and gentlemen, you may never know the depth of the person of Father Costa Sitaris, the director of St. Basil's Academy for so many years. He is a man of great faith, and as you said before, a strong belief that the Holy Spirit guides the church. You have to know that this man takes in his hands every day the academy of children that some come from either broken homes or no family at all. I've had the honor of working with Father Costa for so many years, 35 years, starting from our days when he allowed us to come to Ionian Village to work with him and to learn about children. He is truly a man of faith who knows how to speak to your children and to your grandchildren and bring Christ into their lives and allow them to express their faith about the Lord to all in their midst. And he has undertaken the amazing responsibility of the Academy, and he has made them a family. It's something that each one of us in our own ministries, and even those of us who are fathers and grandfathers, we dream for our own families to be that united. So really, I stand tonight humbled by His Eminence Metropolitan Evangelos and with the blessings of Archbishop Elpidophoros to share my personal love for the Sitaris family and also the blessings that we ask God to continue Father Costa many more years of health and happiness. And Basil and Aaron, do you mind if I say it? That your in-laws will see the joy of their children's children like young olive plants around their tables. Father Costa, Presbytero Val, and friends, God bless you and thank you very much. Have a beautiful evening.
Thank you, Father. Now it's a pleasure to introduce to you the president of the PGEI of America Charitable Foundation, the purpose of being here tonight, this wonderful organization, Mr. James Logothetis. Mr. Logothetis.
Children of St. Basil, welcome all. I'd like to thank Jimmy Paulos for doing a great job tonight. Thank you. Always friend of Pan Gregorian. I'd like to thank Agapios Kiritsis, who's been my counterpart throughout the whole year. I'd like to thank George Siamboulis, who is not here tonight. Unfortunately, his wife is a little ill. Mr. Dimitrios Kafitsas, who is the president of Pan Gregorian of Metro New York. Chris Scarpandonis, president of PGE of New England. George Moustakas, president of PGE of Upper New York. Thank you for being here. I'd also like to thank our vendors, Pepsi Cola, who is a strong supporter of Pan Gregorian, and of this function, Driscoll Foods, who is our primary vendor, strong supporter, and a good friend. Alma Bank, thank you, Mr. Valiotis, for being here tonight. Olympic Payroll, Team 4 Foods, Cremo Land, Echo Lab, and Nestle. I'd like to welcome also for the first time Marathon Energy, who is going to be a strong supporter. Metro Merchant Services also, thank you. I'd like to thank everybody who is here tonight, because without you, this function could never be done. All of us, all of you are all philanthropists, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's been 20 years since I'm standing here, and it's been an honor being your president. I thank you. I want to thank my board of trustees, who has helped me throughout the whole vision that we have for this foundation and for the company. Our foundation was started by the founder of Pangagorian, George Manolios. And after the company was formed, he envisioned of giving back to the community. So the foundation was born a year after. And I can truly say that after $2.5 million, his vision, his mission has been accomplished. However, our mission is not accomplished yet. We have a lot to go. Tonight, we are giving back to some of the brightest children in the state, scholarships amounting to $22,000. I want to thank everybody who participated this year in the scholarships. I want to thank the committee of the scholarship awards for a job well done. The committee chairman, Mr. George Antonio, thank you very much. Tonight we are honoring Father Costa Sidaras. And I met him when I first took over the foundation. And the first time I met him was when I went to St. Basil's. It's been over 20 years that we are supporting St. Basil's. And we will be supporting St. Basil's for many, many years. So when I first met Father Sidaras, I thought to myself, what an extraordinary man, and what a great job he's doing with these kids. I fell in love with him, with the academy, with Father Sidaras, and the directors up there right off from the first year. And we've been back every year in May, putting on a huge picnic, which is, if you haven't gone, you need to be there. Mark your calendars. It's every May or June, depending on the availability. He's an extraordinary man, great charm, and he's one of my favorite people, but don't tell them. You see the faces of these kids when you go up to the academy, and you see the gratitude and thankfulness for what we do for these children. I mean, you see on their faces, they light up like a candle, and you leave there and you feel a bit of gratitude when you leave there, because you're there for them. And we're always will be there for them. We will never forget these children. Tonight we are giving the Academy $15,000 for the children. And we are also taking these children, because it's their wish, to the Rockefeller Center for Christmas time, and they can do their ice skating. everybody for being here. And last but not least, I want to thank Yulia Vergis for an incredible job you've done tonight. I'm sure George Manolios and my father-in-law John Sagularis is up above watching us tonight with a big smile on their face. Thank you very much. I also want to thank, we do this every year, why? The most important people who bring up non-dysfunction, we almost forget. And without these girls, Espina, Zoe, Maria, and Tony, this will never be accomplished, believe me. They've been working on this for the last 3 months. And they left the office last night at 2 in the morning. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lefetis. You know, you can't be Greek and not think for a moment at some point in your life about Greek history and think about the writings of people like Socrates and Aristotle and Pythagoras and think about what they spoke about in their writings, which was new ideas, creativity, and courage. And you can draw such a wonderful parallel between their writings and what this organization is all about. The idea of one man back in the 1980s created an opportunity for people to show their courage to take that idea and see an organization grow into a successful organization. And as Dr. Kutra said before, and he said it so well, this is more than just an organization that's a buying group for the restaurants and diner owners and members of the organization. It is a pillar of our own Greek society. It is an organization that we look to for support. It also gives us identity on a state, national, and even on an international level. And as Greek Americans, we should be very proud of that, whether we're restaurant owners or not. The success of Pan Gregorian is a success for all Greeks, for all Greek Americans, and for everyone who follows in their footsteps. So tonight, you have before you a glass of champagne. I ask you to please raise it as we celebrate the 35th anniversary for this Pan Gregorian Foundation, and we celebrate tonight the awarding of these dollars and important dollars to the mission and work that's being done at St. Basil's Academy. Hear, hear to everyone. In order to make the presentation tonight to St. Basil's and to Father Constantine, there isn't anyone at all, and ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to please just give me a few more minutes of your time. There isn't anyone who could better introduce the work of Father Constantine and the great work of St. Basil's Academy than an individual who has literally lived through it for many, many years. A successful individual with the law firm of Morris Cohen, but most importantly, his other claim to fame is that he is the son of Father Constantine. It is my honor to introduce Mr. Basil Sitaris to come up and say a few words and to introduce our honored guests.
Thanks so much. Good evening, everyone. Your Eminence, Consuls General, like my wife Irini and I are honored to be here. And I in particular am blessed to have been invited to deliver these remarks as we honor St. Basil Academy and my father, the Reverend Constantine Sitaris, who's joined by his wife and my mother, Yoria. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts to the Pan Gregorian Enterprises, and also to Agapios Kiritsis, who through the Ionian Village has known me for almost my entire life and asked me to speak tonight. As you all may know, St. Basil Academy is a Greek Orthodox home for children in need and was the vision of Archbishop Athenagoras, a vision that became a reality 75 years ago. The Academy is located on the Hudson River in the beautiful Hudson Valley, just about 1 hour north of New York City. An interesting piece of history. The Academy is located on the former estate of Jacob Rupert, the owner of the Yankees from 1915 to 1939, and the infamous contract of Babe Ruth, who had left the provincial Red Sox for the evil Empire Yankees, was signed at that very same estate on a table that remains in the main building of the Academy to this very day. And though I might be biased, this contract signing by one of the greatest players in history pales in comparison to the accomplishments of St. Basil Academy and my father. So what else is important to know about St. Basil Academy? It was named after St. Basil the Great, my patron saint and one of the three holy hierarchs of our church, who was the founder of many orphanages, hospitals, and homes for the elderly in 4th century Caesarea in Asia Minor. He is considered one of the greatest philanthropists of our church and a founder of the modern day hospital concept. St. Basil Academy is the only licensed Greek Orthodox residential child care facility for Orthodox children in America. Importantly, St. Basil Academy is wholly self-sufficient, not on the operating budget of the Archdiocese, instead relying on the philanthropy of the Greek Orthodox community, both through individual and family donations and through the generosity of groups such as your own, Philoptikos, Ahepa, and Daughters of Penelope, among others. And this self-sufficiency has remained, even through the global recession of 2008 and through other financial difficulties that have arisen through the Greek community, both abroad and here at home. Through it all, the Academy has persevered and remained financially strong through the tireless efforts of my father and the team that he has built around him, and because of the philanthropy of groups and individuals like those of you in this room here tonight. From its humble origins until today, the Academy has expanded in scope to a 360-degree residential child care center with modern dormitories, a gymnasium, auditorium, indoor swimming pool, beautiful chapel, library, and all the necessary comforts of a loving home. So who is this home for? Although circumstances may vary, generally speaking, these are children whose parent or guardian lack the ability to care for them, or in the most tragic circumstances, the parents are no longer with us in this world. The Academy thus fills this need to provide love, shelter, food, education, protection, and a home. And the Academy ministers to the entirety of the children's lives, mind, body, and a Christian spirit, with the goal being that they will grow to become healthy, wholesome, and well-rounded Orthodox Christians and productive members of society with vision and hope. To help achieve this result, the children are not sequestered from society. And so the children attend public schools local to the Academy, where they are allowed to have a normal life with all the privileges and rites of passage of a rich childhood and adolescence. Academia, athletics, friendship, learning to drive, studying for and taking the SATs, applying for college, attending prom, and graduation. But the Academy does not disappear after high school. Through my father's vision, the Academy also offers a bridge program to high school graduates who can reside at the Academy through college, graduate school, and career placement. The Academy also is expanding to include a family program for single mothers of children and adolescents who similarly need the love and support of our church and Greek Orthodox community. If you'll indulge me just a few more minutes, let me speak of a few of the amazing youths that have come through the Academy, who are some of these children, now young adults, today, many of whom I've had the privilege of calling my friends. There's Andreas, a working actor in Hollywood. There's my friend Spiros, a graduate of Baruch College and now a VP at Citibank, who along with his wife just welcomed their first child into the world. And there's Stella, who my father had the privilege of walking down the aisle at her own wedding and whose three children now all call him Papu. These are but three of the myriad success stories, one might call them miracles, directly attributed to St. Basil Academy and Father Costa. My father, who I am sure most of you in this room know quite well, either personally or through his works. In addition to leading the Academy through one-third of its entire history, he led the Ionian Village program in Greece from 1972 through 1996. And in further addition to all of the work we have just spoken about here tonight, my father also spearheads for the Archdiocese an expansive ministry for the clergy and their families and their financial well-being, along with the Archdiocese Center for Family Care. But that is not all. Father Costas is a pure Renaissance man, a true artist of painting and of crafts, all on display in the priceless dollhouse that he crafted for my mother and his beloved wife for over a decade. A devourer of books and literature, a world traveler, which has come down to me, from my parents' honeymoon across Europe, a pilgrimage through the Holy Land, to the rural countryside of Romania with his friends and spiritual brothers several years ago, and even an odyssey with me, his son, through Russia about 10 years ago. The Odyssey. I am sure all of us here are quite aware of the exploits of Odysseus, but that is just one third of the story. The Odyssey is also about Telemachus, the son on a quest for the father, and about Penelope, the wife of Odysseus, mother to Telemachus, the ever faithful heart of the story. So in conclusion, and I know my father shares this sentiment, this is not just about me speaking to you all about him, but also of my loving mother and his supportive wife, the Holy Spirit to our family trinity. Throughout our shared history as Hellenes, we have been telling this same story. The ideals of the father, the love of the mother, and the son's eternal quest to carry on that legacy. Unlike Alexander, who was driven by and succeeded in surpassing his father, Philip, both of Macedon, both of Greece, I know that I will never be as great as my father. But considering all of his accomplishments, particularly through St. Basil Academy, which we are here to celebrate tonight, I can live with that. So please raise a glass to St. Basil Academy, to Father Costas, and to our loving wives. Thank you.
Another round of applause. Wonderful remarks from Basil about St. Basil's Academy. Absolutely. So deserving. In a moment, I'm going to be inviting up some individuals so we can go through our award ceremony, which we would love you all to give us your attention on. But before I do that, I want to take 1 minute. Before you heard Mr. Logothetti speak about the foundation, and in his very humble way, he spoke about the staff, the board, and all of you. But again, never takes the credit for being the leader of this great organization for more than 20 years. And I think you will agree that with all the hard work and dedication, it does take one individual to have their guiding hand on the operations and on the vision of what an organization is going to be and what an organization is going to do. And the success of this organization over the 35 years and the $2.5 million in large part comes as a result of the guiding hand of Mr. Logothetti. So a round of applause, please. It's now my honor to introduce members of the Board of Trustees to come up for the award presentations. Would the following individuals please join me at the dais? Mr. Logothetti, Steve Sedaris, Tom Lambros, Antonios Frecas, Andreas Caiafas, Mike Caradenintrio, George Filipatos, Gus Betsas, Nick Callis, Agapios Kiritsis, Harry Mijas, Chris Caramanos, and Tasos Christodoulou. And Mike Niotis as well.
They need to come up.
Would those individuals who I called please come up to the dais for the award presentations?
Tonight is a special night for us, whereas we're honoring, as we said, St. Basil's Academy. And St. Basil's Academy are the faces of these children. And we're also honoring the leader of St. Basil's Academy, Father Constantine Sidaras. First presentation to St. Basil's Academy in recognition for your dedication to Orthodox children in need and providing a safe, nurturing environment for child development, education, spiritual, and material needs. With deep appreciation and gratitude, the Board of Trustees, James Lilithan is president at the 35th Annual Charity Gala. Congratulations. Watch the video. The video that we are showing right now is at the picnic that we go every year in June.
That's me in the middle.
At this time, I'd like to welcome to the podium His Eminence Evangelos to present the award to Father Sidaras. His Eminence Evangelos will present the award Father Constantine Sidaras.
The plaque reads as follows. The Pangregorian Charitable Foundation of America, New Jersey Division, presents the Philanthropia Award for the Constantine Sidaras in recognition for your lifetime achievements, accomplishments, and dedication to the children in need at St. Basil Academy and your purpose in instilling the Orthodox faith in the Greek American community. With deep appreciation and gratitude, Panda Axios and the Board of Trustees, James Lomothetis, President of the 35th Annual Charity Gala here in the Venetian on the 17th of November. Congratulations. Thank you.
No, maybe. I have to thank the Fedis, the Pat Gregorian Foundation, Pat Gregorian Enterprises for all of these years of support to St. Basil Academy. I'm truly humbled and gratified that you recognize the work of this incredible mission and ministry called St. Basil Academy that for 75 years has been in the business of saving young lives, giving them the opportunity to have a life like you all have. Imagine if something happened to you as parents. Where would your children go if there was no one around? Well, the church said, we will offer a place, a home, a school, a security, love, church, all of those things for 75 years. We could not have done it without the help of Pat Gregorian these past 20 years since I've been there this time around. I have to just express my humility and love for Pat Gregorian, Mr. Logothetis, your father-in-law, John Sekularis, George Sambulis, and all of you. Agapio is now stepping up to the plate. Continue the work. You're doing God's work. You have the grace and energy of the Holy Spirit working through you. Just let it flow. Let it do what you have to do for the good of humankind. Not only we as Greek Orthodox Christians, but we impact the world with every kindness that we may do to any individual. Know that you've done that to these young people. Through the ages, through these last 75 years, hundreds and hundreds of children have been given the opportunity to live a life of joy, of health, of prosperity, of Christianity. Can you imagine? Can you absolutely imagine? Your church has done that. You have been a part of that mission. You have made it happen and allowed it to happen. We do the work, but you all offer the support. We couldn't do it without your support. Impossible. You heard? Vasily, thank you so much for putting your work out. So every priest is honored today in my person. It's the only way I would stand up here. So every single priest in every single parish does a job that is selfless, is devoted, done out of love for their fellow human being. And the priests that are married know that they couldn't do it without a papatia or a presbytera standing right by them. The sacrifices that our wives make and our children are incredible, and know that. So when you're with your parish priest, give it an embrace. Say a thank you. Say we appreciate the work that you do. It's not just a Sunday morning divine liturgy that he celebrates. He has you in his heart 24/7, and his wife is there beside him. We couldn't do it. I could not have done this without the support of my wife. So Basil is right about Odysseus. Couldn't be more proud of my son and my new daughter, Irini Sophia, and of course the love of my life, my Yuria. Your Eminence, in Ephesus, thank you for being supportive. When you walk onto our campus, our little ones run to you and are amazed that you're able to pick up three of them at a time. That's a joy and a blessing, so thank you. Mr. Logothetis, please. Thank you, sir.
Please. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Okay, while I have everybody up here, I need to give out the church for tonight. Father, don't go yet. At this time, I'd like to present to you a check for $15,000. And also the check, which is from Kalliope and Dimitri Panayotis for $2,000. I'd like to bring up the representatives from Hackensack Medical Center, please. Thank you. Yes. We are presenting, along with the check from the late John Sagalaros, in memory of, we're also presenting two checks tonight. One goes $10,000 for JTCC. The other one goes $10,000 to the Children's Cancer Research. I would like His Eminence Evangelos back to the podium. Check for the Greek Orthodox Metropolis of New Jersey for the amount of $10,000. Representative from Ronald McDonald House. Sending a check to the Greek division of Ronald McDonald House for the amount of $5,000. Representative from Rutgers University Foundation. They will be receiving a check for $5,000. Hellenic Relief Foundation first. Representative from Hellenic Relief Foundation. Mr. Phil Vogels. We are presenting to you tonight, sir, a check for $5,000.
Thank the Pangregorians. This is a tremendous support. On behalf of the families in Greece that our organization was founded, we provide food for the needy families. And this year, we will honor your donation on behalf of the Pangregorians for our January food donation. Thank you very much.
The representatives from the Ascension Greek Orthodox Church. We are presenting a check for you, sir, tonight in the amount of $5,000.
Thank you.
Thank you very much on behalf of the Parish Council of the Greek Orthodox Church of the Ascension and all of its organizations. It's a beautiful gift. God bless.
St. Anne and Greek Orthodox Church. all the Pagan words for your generosity. Thank you very much.
St. Athanasius Church, Paramus.
On behalf of Father Mayores and the Parish Council of St. Athanasius, we thank you for your gift. Thank you very much, the Pagan Gordon.
St. Demetrius Church of Berthing. Scholarship award this year for number one, which is the George Manolio Scholarship Award, will be going to Julia E. Sales. Julia? Congratulations. The second award is going to Sofia Kotolios, and it will be presented by the grandson, Emmanuel Logothetis, which is the Johnny Sakellaris Scholarship Award. She will be going to Northeastern University in Boston. Michalis Babas, if you want to come up too. Will be receiving on behalf of Sophia.
Thank you. On behalf of my niece Sophia, that she could not be here tonight to receive this award, I would like to thank the committee for this generous gift. Also, I would like to thank all the members and the stockholders of Pan Gregorian, that we all know they are the ones that raise most of the money for this event and also for the scholarships. Also, I would like to thank the person that this award was named after, the late Mr. Jan Sakellaris. He was a great man, and all of us, we remember him for his love and passion for Hellenism. May God rest his soul. Thank you again.
The third scholar- scholarship will go to Valencia Divorni Theoparidis in the amount of $3,000. She will be attending the Ernest Mario School of Pharmacy at Rutgers University. Elizabeth Gallo. She will be attending the School of Engineering at Rutgers University. The scholarship amount is $2,000. Scholarship. Alexander G. Rudy, who will be attending Purdue University in Indiana, the amount of $2,000. Seventh scholarship, Nicholas Thomas McGafferty, Rutgers University, $2,000. Scholarship goes to Emmy Ann Ambrosio, who is attending Ohio State University, the amount of $2,000. Her grandfather was a stockholder of Pagrigorian Enterprises.
Attention for just a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to please be seated for just one moment. And I need your complete attention. Thank you. As I mentioned to you earlier,
There is a wonderful, strong bond and connection between Pan Gregorian and the metropolis of New Jersey. And we as the faithful are very fortunate to have a wonderful spiritual leader who guides us each and every day and gives us not only the tenderness of his heart, but the strength of his vision. It is my honor and privilege, and I ask you to please stand as he is called to the dais to introduce our spiritual leader, His Eminence Metropolitan Evangelos.
Being that you're standing, I would like to ask that we pause for a moment of silence, bringing to mind and offering a prayer for our beloved John Sekelaris, who is no longer with us physically, yet who is watching from heaven above and rejoicing with us and with the many successes of Pan Gregorian. For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your departed servant, Ioannis, for Christ our God, and to you be some glory. To your eternal Father, your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and always, and to the age of ages. Amen. Ότι σοι ανάσταση ζωή και μακάρι ανάπαυση. Του κοιμηθέντος δούλου σου Ιωάννου, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξα να πέμπαμε στον άξιο Πατρί, του Παναγίου και Αγαθό, και ζωοποιώ σου πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Όλοι μαζί. Αιωνία η μνήμη, αιωνία η μνήμη, αιωνία αυτού η μνήμη. Χαίρομαι και ήταν διότι για μια ακόμη φορά καθίστε ανασύγκριση. Here we are at our second home, the Venetian, celebrating the many offerings and philanthropic work of Pan Gregorian Enterprises and Philanthropic Foundation. I would like to congratulate Mr. Lobafetis and all who with him and together with him work diligently and faithfully so that the philanthropic work of the church through this tremendous organization is being fulfilled for the benefit of our people, irrelevant of race, color, or creed. St. Basil's Academy is one of the institutions of the Archdiocese, which has been the loving mother of hundreds and hundreds of children throughout these 75 years since its establishment. And Father Kostas Sidoras, the most competent director of this institution, deserves a round of applause because he is not only a tremendous administrator, but he is a loving husband, he is a loving father, and he is a beloved friend of many, many people, including us, the clergy, the hierarchy of this sacred church here in the United States, and especially here in our metropolis of New Jersey. I thank the Pan Gregorians for their contribution to the Academy, to the parishes, to the metropolis, and all the medical facilities and institutions which year in, year out benefit for the benefit of those who are ill, whether it's research, whether it's medicine, whether it's pharmaceuticals, whether no matter what, there is only one thing that we do know, that Pan Gregorian and philanthropy are synonymous. I wish you a blessed evening. And I ευχαριστώ βραδινό μια έτσι μια ωραία σε αυτή την ωραία εκδήλωση που μας φιλοξενεί πάντα το Pan Gregorian και θα ήθελα ιδιαίτερως να τονίσω και με έμφαση να σας πω ότι ένας από τους μεγαλύτερους και θερμότερους υποστηρικτές της Ακαδημίας μας είναι ο κύριος Δημήτρης Κουρτζέλας. Jim Κουρτζέλας, the owner of the Venetian, is one of the most sincere and anonymous, silent contributors of our academy and our children. So please, when you see Jimmy, I know all of you know him. Please thank him for all his contributions, both to the metropolis, to the church at large, and to philanthropy. Εύχομαι και πάλι, όπως αυτές τις μέρες είναι ευλογημένες από τον Θεό, εύχομαι όπως τα Χριστούγεννα, τα οποία θα εορτάσουμε, θα είναι πραγματικά ευφρόσινα, θα είναι πραγματικά ευλογημένα και θα ήθελα για μία ακόμη φορά να συγχαρώ τον πατέρα Κωνσταντίνο Σιταρά, ο οποίος ανέλαβε μία ακαδημία και την διακονεί μέχρι σήμερα τα τελευταία 20 χρόνια. Όμως πρέπει να κάνω μία αναφορά στους εξής. Στον Μακαρίτη τον Πατριάρχη Αθηναγόρα, ο οποίος ως Αρχιεπίσκοπος τότε ίδρυσε την Ακαδημία, να αναφερθώ στον Αρχιεπίσκοπο Μιχαήλ, να αναφερθώ στον Μεγάλο Αρχιεπίσκοπο Ιάκωβο, να αναφερθώ στον Αρχιεπίσκοπο Δημήτριο, να αναφερθώ στον Επίσκοπο και μετά επί τα Μητροπολίτη Μελώης Φιλόθεο, ο οποίος διεικόνησε αυτή την Ακαδημία για 3 ολόκληρα χρόνια, παράλληλα με τα καθήκοντά του ως Επισκόπου, βοηθού του Μακαλιστού Αρχιεπισκόπου Ιακώβου, το όπως ήταν ο πατήρ Ιωάννης, Father John Gerenaeus, was a director for a long time there, and also Bishop Philip of Atlanta, later Metropolitan Bishop of Atlanta, who spent quite a few years nurturing these children. So you, the Academy, which is the past 20 years, has been in your hands and under your guidance, was led by many capable. I pray to God that the one who follows you, the one who follows you, Father Costa, will be as good or better. Because this church in the United States and this academy, at one time, it was one of the most incredible institutions of the church. I remember going there in the 70s, και τα παιδάκια να τρέχουν τα παιδάκια, ήταν όλο χαρά, παρόλο που ήταν ορφανά και πονεμένα, ήταν γεμάτα χαρά, διότι η Εκκλησία, ο Χριστός, γέμιζε την ψυχή τους με αυτή την χαρά των αγγέλων. Οπότε εμείς ως άγγελοι όλοι οφείλουμε να φτερουργήσουμε, να ανοίξουμε τα φτερά μας και να αγκαλιάζουμε όλα τα παιδιά του κόσμου. Όχι μόνο τα δικά μας τα Ελληνάκια, όλα τα παιδιά του κόσμου, διότι όλα τα παιδιά είναι δημιουργήματα του ιδίου, του μεγάλου και Αγίου Θεού. Χρόνια πολλά. Have a blessed Christmas holiday. Θεός μαζί σας.
Ladies and gentlemen, your dinner will be coming out momentarily. I'd like to invite Mr. Lokothetis back to the microphone for a couple more presentations.
Like I said, this event would not be possible without the hard work of 4 young ladies in our office, who is the backbone of this office. All of them, Tony, Zoe, Despina, and Maria. Can you please come up to the podium? Tony, thank you very much. We need a big round of applause for these ladies. Thank you.
As I mentioned to you, dinner will be out momentarily, and as dinner is being served, I'd like to take a moment to invite up an individual who was introduced to you earlier for a couple of brief remarks, Mike Tanousis, who's running for Assembly in New York. Mike?
Thank you very much. I'll be very quick. I know I'm the only thing that stands between you and your dinner, so I'll be as quick as possible. My name is Michael Tanousis. I am the son of Cypriot refugees. My parents are from Gdynia. My mother left her house one day in 1974 and never returned. I'm a former prosecutor. I was a prosecutor for 8 years. I did 5 years in the Bronx and 3 years at the Staten Island District Attorney's Office. Last year in Staten Island, I prosecuted 2 murder cases. During one of those cases, which was the murder of a woman and her babies by stabbing them to death, is when I saw the state legislature in New York State pass the bail reform laws. They're making it dangerous for the residents of New York State. I wanted to do something about it. I looked into it more. Then I saw the real estate laws that they've passed. After I saw all that, I realized I wanted to make a difference. I spoke to our community here, to Philip Christopher, to Despin Axiotakis, to Andy Komodromos, and I filed to run for State Assembly. I am happy to be here today because the Pan Gregorian is the prime example of the Cypriot and Greek American dream. I'm here because I'm seeking your help, and together we can do everything and anything. And we are trying to keep this seat within the Greek community. This is a seat that belonged to Matthew Maronis, then to Nicole Malliotakis, and I'm hoping to hold on to it and keep it within the Greek community, and I look forward to your support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mike. Ladies and gentlemen, as dinner is going to be coming out in just a moment, I can tell you that our program has concluded. On behalf of the Pan Gregorian Enterprises and Pan Gregorian, I want to thank all of you for coming out to tonight's event, particularly those of you who traveled from out of state. Welcome. We wish you safe passage on your way home tonight. Now we want you to just enjoy the meal, have some fun. There'll be some great music. We want to see everyone out on the dance floor and be able to have an opportunity to meet other people from around the area. Thank you again on behalf of Pan Gregorian. Kalioriksi.
Thank you. saga, koskus pregari panlaga, matu saga sinaplisu, koskumase monarkisu.
Thank you. Thank you. πετάω όταν αγκαλιά μου τώρα μου σε κρατάω. Είμαι εμασμένος, ξέρω για που πάω. Ένα μόνο ξέρω το πόσο σ' αγαπάω. Είμαι στα πλάι μου, όταν σε κομμάει μου. Κι όταν είσαι χωριά μου, με λέω στην αγωριά μου. Thank you.
tribuna.
Oh, Peace out. remember